If you've watched any popular renditions of Sherlock Holmes, such as BBC's Sherlock or ABC's Elementary, you've heard him mention the phrase brain attic or attic theory. What is this? We're going to cover all that and more in this episode of Geek Bites. Stay tuned. While it's covered a bit more in BBC's Sherlock than Elementary, attic theory is something that's a kind of key point to the way Sherlock thinks and the way his mind works. Attic theory, or the brain attic, is an analogy to describe the way the brain stores and retrieves information. This makes things actually much easier to break down. So basically, Sherlock sees the brain as an attic in the top of someone's house. It's a physical concrete space that has a limited amount of room. This can have a chimney, it can have lights, it can have windows, it can have whatever. It doesn't matter what it looks like or whatever. It's a very confined, concrete, non-expanding space where you store your information. Now you have the choice to choose to fill your attic with the random, useless information of day-to-day life and bury all the important things, or you can choose to throw out information you don't need and only store what's actually important to you and to your work in your attic. At least the way Sherlock sees it. This is why in BBC's Sherlock, Sherlock claims to have ignorance of the solar system and thinks that the sun might revolve around the Earth instead of the Earth revolving around the sun, and says it doesn't matter whether or not he knows that because that's not relevant to his work. However, later on he shows that this isn't really true because he uses his pretty extensive knowledge of astronomy to actually save a young boy's life. That's the thing about the brain, is you don't entirely get to choose what you remember and what you don't remember. However, Sherlock's attic theory actually has a little bit of merit. Now, most would describe the brain as a never-ending attic, if we're using the attic analogy, of space. You can never run out of space to store things. What you can do, however, is store things on top of other things and bury things. The more recent you recalled something or stored something in your brain, the more likely you are to remember it. So, if we're using the attic analogy, you can put however much stuff you want in your attic, but if you keep piling more stuff on top, it's going to be a lot harder to get to that original stuff you stored in there. However, there are other things which have a clear path to them because you reference them all the time, and so you keep them cleaned off at all times. This theory actually applies a bit more accurately to the way our working memory, a part of our short-term memory, actually works. Studies and research and hundreds of years of data have shown that we can only really store up to maybe 7 things, although now it's considered to be closer to 4 or 5, within our working memory. This is, you know, say you're trying to remember a sequence of random numbers or a sequence of random words. At absolute best, you're only going to store about 7. So your working memory very much acts like an attic. You can only store so many things in there. So to Sherlock, why bother storing whether or not the Earth rotates around the sun when he can store more relevant details to the case that he's working on? However, things like that, which you're taught in school at a very young age, like I said, you don't really have all that much of a choice as to what you remember in your long-term memory. The core lesson to learn from Sherlock's brain attic theory, however, is the idea that if there's information that is pertinent to your life or to your work, things that you need to remember, you need to keep them active in your brain and keep them as the things that you're actively putting in and taking out of your attic. Otherwise, it's going to get buried under the useless, trivial details of life. While it's not the most accurate analogy for how the brain works, Sherlock's attic theory certainly is an interesting one, and creates a very interesting philosophy for the way one lives life, or at least the way Sherlock lives life and thinks about things. What do you think about attic theory? Do you think it holds any merit, or do you think he's just nuts and that's the side effect of being a drug addict in ABC's Elementary rendition of Sherlock? Let me know in the comment section down below. I hope you enjoyed this little bit of a different episode of Geek Bites. Let me know what you thought about it as well in the comment section down below. Be sure to subscribe, leave a like on the video, leave a favorite if you feel like it, and otherwise, I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.